Hello and welcome to Google I/O 2022. Thank you for joining our developer session, Building for Everyone, the importance of representative data. In this session, we'll cover a few things: how data representation carries an elevated significance in AI and digital products. We'll discuss a few helpful practices and resources developers can use to address data quality and representation bias in their projects. And we'll introduce TaskMate Beta, Google's experimental crowdsourcing tool, as a concept to further improve data quality and representation. My name is Hannah, and I'm a user experience researcher working on Google's Next Billion User Initiative. As part of Google's Next Billion User Initiative, our team has a focus on making technology helpful, relevant, and inclusive for people new to the internet. To learn more about Google's NBU initiative, please visit nextbillionusers.google. To that end, one of the lessons that we learn over and over again is that data quality and representation largely determine the success of our digital products and AI systems. This is true as measured by metrics as diverse as performance, fairness, robustness, safety, and even scalability. While these shortcomings happen early in the development cycle, the impacts of poor data and representation on model performance are often opaque and delayed. And these effects compound into major negative impacts downstream. Paradoxically, for AI researchers and developers, data is often the least incentivized aspect of the work and is viewed as operational relative to the lionized work of building novel models and algorithms. This is true even though intuitively, AI developers understand that data quality matters, often spending inordinate amounts of time on data tasks. In a recent study, "Everyone Wants to Do the Model Work, Not the Data Work: Data Cascades in High-Stakes AI," we found most organizations fail to create or meet any data quality standards, undervaluing data work vis-a-vis model development, and failing to define or meet any standards of representativeness. This is especially important in markets where users are coming online for the first time, where the model of one user, one phone, one account is not standard, and the assumption of continuous connectivity doesn't hold. This research has also documented how inattention to data needs causes negative downstream effects, resulting in technical debt over time. Negative performance resulting from inattention to data is also widely prevalent, affecting 92% of AI practitioners that we spoke with. So what can be done to proactively address these downstream impacts? We're going to hear now from Ben Hutchinson, who researches data ethics inside Google, for some best practices around data collection.
Thank you, Hannah. My name is Ben, and I'm a software engineer on Google's responsible AI team. To help avoid unexpected consequences later on, it's critical to prioritize high-quality, representative data collection from the start. The first step to building representative datasets is knowing your users. Since the world is incredibly diverse, data practitioners need to be clear from the onset of the specific geographic and demographic populations they intend to serve, and ensure they have a plan to source data which reflects their intended audience. You may start by asking yourself, is my data sampled in a way that represents my users? For example, will the end product be used for all ages, but I only have training data from senior citizens? Is my data sampled in the real-world setting? For example, will it be used year-round, but I only have training data from the summer? After having a solid understanding of the user base, developers should consider the following leading practices to source data that is representative of the real world. Set explicit goals around which region of the world you want your data to represent. Share these goals with your project team. Source data directly from the respective region or audience that you intend to serve, so that your model and product better understand and reflect local nuances. Once you've collected your data, use exploration and visualization tools, such as Google's Know Your Data, in order to check for biases. And if you do find biases, make sure to document them, so that they don't cause nasty surprises for your end users. Yes, data collection can be a tedious, time-consuming process, and it is just one step in a product's development. However, as Hannah has pointed out, it's a critical step, and it can have significant implications for the success or failure of your end product. It's important that developers give the data collection step the respect it deserves and ensure it reflects the makeup of the user base you intend to serve to mitigate any negative downstream impacts. Another tool developers may want to consider when sourcing representative data are general crowdsourcing tools like Taskmate. Crowdsourcing tools are particularly helpful when developers need to quickly create high-quality custom datasets. However, in some cases, to get the right expertise, you might need to seek out more specialized tools. If a crowdsourcing platform is used, it's important for data practitioners to be upfront in identifying themselves and their organizations, fully disclosing the purpose of the task and how the data will be used. This is especially critical when data might contain sensitive or identifying information. Finally, paying crowd workers fairly for their work is not only equitable, but enables sustainable relationships between taskers and task providers. This way, data contributors have all the information they need to meaningfully decide whether a specific data task is right for them to participate in. And here to speak more about crowdsourcing as a solution for creating high-quality representative datasets is Mike Knapp, co-founder of Taskmate, Google's experimental crowdsourcing platform.
Thanks for the introduction, Ben. Hi there, my name is Mike Knapp, and I'm a product manager on Google's Next Billion User initiative. Because we know from our research that it's really hard to create diverse and inclusive datasets, we've been experimenting with a new crowdsourcing platform called Taskmate. The goal of this experimental product is to enable developers to reach previously hard to access diverse crowds with a focus on unrepresented regions and languages. Businesses can customize their tasks to suit a large range of use cases. Some examples include data collection, labeling, and fieldwork to improve representation and ML fairness in products, conduct surveys, and more. Meanwhile, taskers can use the app to complete tasks and earn money easily. Let's look at a practical example of where Taskmate has been used by the Google research team to expand the language capability of Google products such as Maps.
Hi, my name is Emila, and I'm an interaction designer on Google's Next Billion User initiative and co-founder of Taskmate. Taskmate is currently in an experimental beta testing phase in 3 countries, India, Mexico, and Kenya. Let's now look at a selection of features on Taskmate. It's simple to create a data collection project on Taskmate. You don't need any code to get started. You can use a UI-based visual editor to design a screen-by-screen workflow for your taskers. There is a set of pre-made task steps, which range from showing a map to direct taskers to a location, recording audio, taking photos, to viewing multimedia and answering questions. You can set up these steps in any order you like and customize them with your instructions. These steps are designed to simplify and streamline the experience for taskers and make the task easier to get right. Furthermore, Taskmate is integrated with Google Sheets, allowing you to quickly enter or export your data and enable quick pilots to test your task designs. Once you've created and piloted your task, Taskmate provides you tools to help scale up your project. You can utilize our API to create a more seamless integration and automate creation and management of tasks. Taskmate also enables you to set criteria for the taskers you want to reach, including regions, language proficiencies, and demographics. If you already have your own taskers, you can add them straight to the project also. We know quality can be a big challenge when creating a dataset, so Taskmate has created a variety of quality control features. There is peer validation where you can set up consensus on questions, or you can send the results from one task to another person to validate. We also have automated quality checks for things like audio recordings that have too much background noise, photos that are too dark or blurry, and GPS checks to ensure field tasks are done at the right location. There are also automated privacy features like face and license plate blurring for photos taken inside the Taskmate app. For taskers, we've tried to make the experience simple and enjoyable. Our mobile-first approach creates accessible opportunities for people to do tasks and earn anywhere. It enables a large range of tasks, including field tasks, as well as tasks you can do from home. To see all the current features on the platform, you can check out taskmate.google.com. We've also got a big roadmap ahead, and we're constantly working on delivering additional improvements. Next, we're going to hear about a field data collection project run on Taskmate to develop an agricultural dataset in Kenya.
The mission of Plant Village is to work with smallholder farmers to help them adapt to climate change and mitigate its effects.
We have an application we put into farmers' farms, and they are able to go into the field and they're able to diagnose their crops themselves.
Plant Village combines machine learning models and technologies with human expertise. One of the main challenges we face is validating what's happening on the ground in comparison to what we simulate is happening with our modeling team. We use Taskmate to set tasks for users from here in the US to specific regions in Kenya. Users go to a predetermined location, take a picture of the field, submit it, and then earn income from that. To date, we have collected over 600 images with Taskmate.
Being paid for the tasks is a great benefit.
When you have Taskmate, you can have some money that can be used during tough times.
Taskmate is directly helping our farmers by short-term providing them additional income, and then long-term we're able to validate our AI model results and then reach more people with this highly specific advice.
With Taskmate here, we are talking about technology coming in to help the farmers. We are going to look at the patterns and give solutions.
Today we've talked about how data representation carries an elevated significance in AI and digital products, particularly in unrepresented geographies and communities. Building inclusive products requires a foundation of representative data. Google recognizes this important issue and is experimenting with a crowdsourcing platform called Taskmate to create high-quality, relevant datasets. Taskmate aims to tap into a diverse tasker network, provide flexible tools and intelligent quality controls to help you build more inclusive products. Now, while we're still in beta, we have a lot of really exciting things planned on our roadmap, and we'd love to understand your unique requirements. So if you feel passionately about crowdsourcing and want to participate in our beta program, You can request access to Taskmate Beta by registering your interest at taskmate.google.com, which is also linked in the session resources. When you submit your inquiry, note that you attended this session today in the additional comments field. If you're interested in learning more about the importance of representative data or accessing resources to help mitigate data bias in your own projects, please download our session developer guide linked in the session resources to the right of your screen. Google's Next Billion User initiative aims to create a more inclusive internet for everyone, everywhere. We invite you to watch some of the other amazing NBU sessions. What can we learn from the internet's newest users and Africa's booming developer ecosystem on demand at the IO website under the NBU tag? Learn more about Google's Next Billion User initiative also by visiting nextbillionusers.google. It's been so great to speak with you today about these really important topics. Thanks for watching.